Fornica Mountain. Once upon a time, there was a beautiful girl named Jurika. Her hair was like gold, her eyes blue like the sky, and her lips red like roses. The beautiful Jurika was diligent and gentle, and everyone loved her. But Jurika was alone in the world. And that's why she often stood in front of her cottage, staring sadly. As she was sitting there one day, she saw a long queue of ants approaching. Suddenly, they stopped and formed a circle around Jurika. One of the ants came forward and spoke to the girl. "We know you very well, Jurika, and we often admire your diligence. And we also know you're alone in the world. That is why we ask you, come and rule over us as queen. We will build a palace for you, more beautiful and bigger than anything you have ever seen in the world. Only one thing you have to promise, that you will not return to your people. Instead, you will stay with us and forever be the queen of the ants." "I wouldn't want anything else but to stay with you," replied Jurika, "as your queen of you, ants, for nothing holds me back to stay among people." And so, Jurika left with the ants and went until they reached a place that seemed ideal for building a palace. The ants built a beautiful palace in no time, adorned with flowers and leaves. For Jurika, life was beautiful as one of the ants, and she turned out to be a gentle queen who always had good counsel for ants. So, with so much love, the ants were raising their palace, adorning it with more and more beautiful flowers. From the outside, Jurika's palace seemed to be a mountaintop. One day, as she was standing in her room, she heard noises around the mountain and nervous voices. "Our house is about to fall apart," the ants shouted. "Wicked people get into it." "It's okay," Jurika said. "I shall solve this problem." And, having said that, Jurika came out of her palace, where she saw a handsome young man, the son of an emperor. "Who are you? Why are you here?" Jurika asked assertively.
"Apologies, beautiful girl," the young man replied.
"You have my honest word that I will be a devoted defender of ants starting from today. How could I have imagined that the ants had such a beautiful queen?"
"Thank you," replied Jurika. "I'm only asking that no man ever enters my kingdom." Having said these words, Jurika disappeared as if the mountain had swallowed her. But the emperor's son remained there, in front of the mountain, as if he had been dreaming. He still had hope that the beautiful queen would come back and he would see her again. He stayed there for a long time, but he only saw endless queues of ants. That night, Jurika was very uneasy. Never before had it seemed to her that there was not enough air in her kingdom. But now she wanted to go out in the sun and fresh air, but she was afraid and did not want to break her promise to the ants. Still, Jurika was getting sadder by the day. Then the ants asked her with fear, "Queen, do you not like us anymore?" But Jurika replied, "Oh, I just want to go out a little, and before the sunset I will be back to you." The ants agreed, but when Jurika came out, everything had changed. Time had passed since she had left her cottage, and the emperor's son was now an old man. Jurika knew nothing around her, and, looking at the mountain that the ants had built in time, she realized that that was her home now. Returning to the palace, the ants immediately brought her the finest flowers and nectar and dewdrops. And they decided to build a palace higher and higher until a great mountain appeared. And this mountain is called Fornica today.